afternoon and welcome to day one of the ISSF World Cup here in Munich, Germany. We have a packed crowd here in the finals hall, ready for today's final. Just the one final today. The time is just coming up to 1:30 local time here in Germany for this 10-metre air rifle women's final. My name is Rory McAllister and my guest this afternoon of Denmark is Mikkel Hansen. Mikkel, hello.
Hello.
It's very nice to have you here. Thank you
very
much.
Glad to be here.
For coming along. Now, I know you're here with many of your teammates.
Yes, I am.
How's your trip to Germany been so far?
So far, it's been good. It's a rather long drive here, but, you know, it's all worth it. So far, we've got one of our girls in the final, which for a minor country like Denmark is really great. So it's a good start.
So as Mikkel's just pointed out, Rikke Mengi Ibsen. How was my pronunciation on that? Rikke?
It was okay.
Rikke?
Yeah.
Rikke. Rikke Mengi Ibsen is shooting at firing point H. We're about to move over to our announcer, Jamie Stangroom. Here are the official introductions for our athletes for this final.
The final competition for the 10-metre air rifle women's event will now begin. So let's meet the athletes. On firing point A, representing the People's Republic of China, the world number 9 is making her fourth final appearance in the last year and is fresh from Fort Benning where she reached World Cup gold. It's Wu Mingyang.
This is Wu Mingyang, our first athlete on firing point A, representing the People's Republic of China, ranked 9th in the world and took gold at the World Cup in Fort Benning a few weeks ago. This is her fourth appearance in a final of a World Cup.
And looking to build on the best finish of 6th place in Munich, Canada 2017 is Chung
Eun-hae of Korea, who I'm sure will have her sights on the World Championships as well as this final this afternoon.
Representing the People's Republic of China, the 20-year-old Junior Asian Championship gold away from Tehran 2016 and the debut year of World Cup competition to today appearing in our first ever final is Wang Luyao.
So the second athlete from China, this is Wang Luyao. Her first appearance in a final of a World Cup. Took gold at the Asian Championships in Tehran as a junior 2 years ago.
This month and is no stranger to Munich taking silver in this very same hall just last year. Let's welcome back Gabriela Vognarova.
Gabriela Vognarova of the Czech Republic won the silver medal here at Munich last year, 2017, at the World Cup, and was 7th in the final at Fort Benning a few weeks ago. So let's see how she goes today.
Busy year, including the Sydney Junior World Cup, where she took silver. As for the silver in Changwon, it's Lin Ying-Shin.
So this is Lin Ying-Shin of Chinese Taipei. She's ranked 3rd in the world, so we're expecting something from her this afternoon. She also took silver in Changwon at the World Cup last month.
World Cup bronze in Changwon 2015 and World Cup final silver in the same year coming right here at Munich. It's Apurvi Chandela.
Apurvi Chandela. The Indian team weren't there at Fort Benning a few weeks ago, but they are here very much so in Munich, Germany. She was the World Cup final silver medalist here in Munich in 2015. 25 years old now and ranked 11th in the world. So Ayano Shimizu of Japan, just inside the top 50, ranked 41 at the moment. This is her second appearance in the final of the World Cup in Fort Benning a few weeks ago. She was 6th in the final. So no strangers to these finals, but perhaps expecting bigger things at this afternoon. So Rikke Mengi Ibsen of Denmark, who is from the same team as Mikkel Hansen, my guest this afternoon. Rikke is 43rd in the world. This is her second appearance in a final of a World Cup. She was 9th in the World Cup in Fort Benning last year, but this is her first appearance in a final. But she has competed in World Cups before, so certainly no stranger to competitions with this kind of class of athletes that we have in front of us. So this is how it will work. We have 10 metres that separates the rifle shooters and the targets. They'll shoot a series of five shots and then another series of five shots. Once we get to 10 shots, it moves to single shots and we'll have our first elimination after the 12th shot of this final. So if you are new to shooting, good afternoon to you, or wherever you are around the world, whatever the time is, it's just gone 1:30 here in Munich in Germany for day one of the ISSF World Cup. This is ISSF TV and it's great to have you with us. My name is Rory McAllister and my guest this afternoon is Mikael Hansen of Denmark. So Mikael, you were saying about the long drive. I mean, this is something I've noticed. I mean, me also being a European,
yeah.
We do tend to fly though, because I suppose it's just because we've got the water in between. But I've noticed an awful lot of the other European teams, when it's a central European destination such as Germany, there's a lot of driving that goes on.
Yes, I think mainly it's because it's a bit more convenient and a bit cheaper. I think it's the money that really matters there.
Yeah, of course. And you can all stay together as well. I mean, obviously, yeah. When you're flying, sure, you're flying as a team, but you're separated sometimes on planes.
Exactly.
At least if you all come together, you're all in one minibus, true. You're all staying together. It just helps create the team atmosphere.
Yes, exactly. But yeah, it's true that many many teams drive, especially to Munich, if they are like continental Europeans. I think I saw like Latvia drove here. That must be a longer journey.
Serbian drove here as well. The Serbian team drove.
Okay, I'll stop complaining about our 10-hour drive.
Well, it's a great start for Denmark. Yes, a 10.9 already for Reika Ibsen.
It's doing some good for my nerves.
I mean, it is a nervous time, isn't it, for any finalists? Even
absolutely.
If you are used to the finals, if you've been in the final before.
I don't think you ever get used to the finals, really. Because it's just such a high-pressure situation that you don't really know how you're going to cope with the situation. I don't really think that experience matters too much there. Of course, it helps if you've been in a World Cup final 20 times. But
if you've never won one.
If you've never won one,
if you've been in one 20 times and you've never...
Exactly. And I think oftentimes we've seen these newcomers come into the final and win. And doing it rather easily, actually. At least it looks easy.
Are you talking about the sort of surgence of the Chinese teams and the Indian teams, who often have very young
especially
shooters?
The Chinese, they're really incredibly good at having these young shooters who just perform extremely well. And if I'm not mistaken, we've got two of them here.
Yes.
That old.
Yes, we have Wu Ming Yang, and we also have Wang Lu Yao.
Yeah.
But we also have Ling Ying-Sin of Chinese Taipei as well.
Yeah, she's still a junior. If I'm not mistaken, she competed in Australia, in Sydney, for the Junior World Cup this year.
Yes, I mean, the oldest Chinese shooter, and this is the oldest, is 21 today. But no, you're absolutely right, and I think perhaps it comes with, you know, composure, also good training, discipline, a decent attitude. But perhaps even when you're young, no fear of failure, because
I think you might be right there.
What have you got to lose?
Nothing, basically.
Exactly. Yeah, I mean, I suppose you could almost say the pressure mounts once you've done it many times, and perhaps performances and form is slipping.
But I think these finals, in general, they're very intense. At least that's my own experience with them. So they can be really, really difficult to do well, but really easy to do not so well.
I suppose, like you were saying earlier, you literally just have to take each final each day as it comes, because of course it depends on, almost like you were saying a second ago, Mikael, about travelling, you know, if it's close by, or it's been a long drive, or depending on how you've slept and generally how you're feeling, because, you know, some of these shooters up to a couple of weeks ago were in Georgia, in Fort Benning, and before that were in Changwon.
Yes, that's true.
And before that, in Guadalajara.
Yeah, so it's a lot of travelling. Especially this year, the World Cup program has been really packed.
It has. The finals have certainly come, and the World Cups have come thick and fast. Yeah. So we've had our first five shots then in this final. It's Apurvi Chandala of India who leads on a round score of 53.0. And these are some incredibly high scores as well we're seeing here. Wu Mingyang of the People's Republic of China, 52.4. And Wang Lu Yao on 52.1. Yeah. Ibsen of Denmark, though, still holding strong at 51.9. Because
it's a good start.
It is.
It is, really.
Because the margins here, Mikhail, they're just minute, aren't they?
It's just...
Talk us through some of the technicalities of the targets, for example.
Well, the 10 ring, or you couldn't really call it a ring, it's more of a dot. It's really the size of a of a dot at the end of a sentence. So I think it's like half a millimeter or something. You just have to puncture the circle or the ring to score a 10, but it's really, really, really small, and you're shooting it from 10 meters away in the standing position, which is extremely difficult. So like what they're doing here, especially scores like 50, 52, 53, especially, is under these circumstances really amazing.
Because the rifles, although on your screens right now, we're just seeing Ibsen of Denmark, for example, your fellow teammates.
Yeah.
These rifles aren't light, are they?
No. Maximum weight is 5.5 kilos.
But most of them are around 5, aren't they?
Yes, I think like normally from like standard they would be 4.5 kilos, but most shooters tend to like get it up and around 5.3.
Because you're making additions, aren't you?
Yes.
And each rifle is uniquely styled to your particular face shape, grip, all sorts of things.
Yeah, you won't see one that's similar to another.
No two are ever the same.
No.
So we're now in the second series of five shots for this final. If you have just joined us here on ISSF TV, welcome. It's day one of the World Cup here in Munich, Germany. And before you're thinking, didn't we just have a World Cup a few weeks ago? Yes, we did.
Yes, we did.
We did. And most of us were in Fort Benning, near to Atlanta in Georgia in the United States. We had a wonderful time there. The weather was great. The finals went so well. They went so smoothly. And so far, here in Germany, in Munich, everything's been very efficient and everything's been on time. We've had a good time so far. Some of us have been here a couple of days already.
The Indian girl, she's just shooting absolutely amazing right now. I can see her group from here. It's so tight.
Well, this is what I was thinking in Fort Benning, because you can only beat the shooters who are with you. But I think it would have been interesting had the Indian team have been in Fort Benning, because they're, as you say, incredibly strong.
Yes, they are.
In events like this. And as Mikhail's pointed out, Apurvi Chandala of India, who's leading the competition at the moment. We're just seeing on our screens Lin Ying-Shin, Chinese Taipei. But there's a good crowd here, isn't there? I mean, there's loads of people compared to Fort Benning. I mean, obviously, there's a slightly bigger finals hall. It's obviously arguably more established for a competition, whereas Fort Benning was more of an army training facility. But it's great to see so many people interested in not only the final, but just to see so many people gathered here just for shooting and its growth.
Absolutely. But like Munich is like the shooting capital of the world.
And it's the home of the ISSF.
It is.
So we're seeing some 10.5s and 10.6s across the board, as Mikhail's pointed out earlier in this final. The standard is just so high.
Yes, and again, it's really amazing that they can perform so well under these circumstances, because it's just so difficult.
And they've already had a morning and times of qualification. And
yes.
Arriving here and getting settling in, as we've been establishing.
It's a long day.
So Apurvi Chandala of India, now leads with a difference of 0.9 from Wu Mingyang of the People's Republic of China. And then with a difference of 0.6, it's Ling Ying-Shin. Ibsen of Denmark, still holding strong in the middle of the scoreboard.
Yeah, she's doing well.
At the moment, on a score of 103.6. I mean, just for Reika Ibsen, I mean, for this to be her first final and be performing so well, I mean, she's... If she keeps this up, she's literally just outside a medal.
Yeah.
And anything can change in shooting.
Well, it's her first World Cup final in the air rifle discipline. However, she did qualify for 3P final here last year, if I'm not mistaken.
She did, yeah. She was fourth last year.
Yeah, as well as the European Championship. She came in fourth in the final, if I'm not mistaken. So she is... really experienced, and she's just a really, really great shooter. She works extremely hard and really gets the best out of it. So she's really strong. So it doesn't really surprise me to see her doing so well.
So we've now had 10 shots in this final. We now move to single shots. So it's Apurvi Chandela of India leading at the moment, with Wu Mingyang of China in second position. And as Mikael's just been pointing out, his fellow teammate, Ibsen of Denmark, who has made finals in other competitions. This is just her first final in a World Cup in a 10-meter air rifle. She's now 27 years old, ranked 43rd in the world. Of course, that would change if she picks up a medal here this afternoon.
Had a great shot for her this round.
Yes, the high score of the round, 10.7 from Ibsen of Denmark.
Of course, I'm really happy about that.
And we have our first elimination as well. Ayano Shimizu of Japan, who's finished eighth in this final with a total of 121.1, so she takes her seat. You've got to undo those suits pretty quickly before you go to sit down, haven't you? They're incredibly stiff.
But I have to say about her, she had a pretty rough start, she recovered pretty well from that, I'd say. So she's got absolutely nothing to be sad about. And again, making it into the final of a World Cup, especially in Munich, is just incredible, and really shows how good of a shooter she must be.
I don't think there's ever any shame, is there, in wherever you finish in a final of a World Cup.
Absolutely.
The standard is so high.
Yeah.
So here's Wu Mingyang of the People's Republic of China, who, as Mikael pointed out earlier this afternoon in this final, every single country is aware of the Chinese team.
Yes, they are.
At the moment. I mean, you refer to Denmark as almost a minor country, but as you say, I mean, Ibsen is certainly no stranger to this standard. So it's Chandela who still leads at the moment on 136.6. There's a difference of 0.7 from Wu Mingyang. I mean, this is still just so close in this final. Ibsen of Denmark now moves up to third position. In danger of elimination is Chong of Korea in seventh position at the moment.
Yeah, everything can still happen. And that's the interesting part about these finals and shooting in general, I think, that nothing's ever decided until the last shot. Like, I've seen multiple times that someone's won it on the last shot or lost it on the last shot. And that's the interesting part.
It can all change. I mean, even just in Fort Benning last month, remember Isfan Penny went from eighth to the gold medal.
Yeah, he had an amazing last part of the final.
Yeah, had problems with his rifle too.
Yes.
Survived three elimination processes. Yeah. So as you said, Mikael, I mean, literally things can change. I mean, obviously, as it stands going into the elimination shots, the scoreboard tells the story, but the final story, as it were, is never really in place until those shots have been taken. So, as it turns out, though, in seventh place on a total of 142, eliminated in seventh position is Chong Eun-hae. Well, she seems happy.
Yeah, she should be. She should be. But also now we just talked about the Chinese team. The Korean team is also getting stronger and stronger. And they're really doing some great work out there.
So it's Chandela of India that still leads. If you're just joining this final, this is the 10-metre air rifle women final on day one of the ISSF World Cup here in Munich, Germany. The home, if you like, of international shooting. Here is Chandela, the leader.
She's looking really calm and composed and yeah, really like she's comfortable. Well, it reflects on her scores, so she's most likely comfortable.
10.9 there for Lin.
10.9.
That's from Lin of Chinese Taipei, which is an incredible shot at this stage of the final. That really is.
And absolutely.
And it just means now that there's a gap of 0.5 between Lin of Chinese Taipei and Wu of the People's Republic of China. And there's now only a difference of 0.3. That gap's getting narrower, Mikhail.
Yes, it is.
As this final progresses. That was 0.7 a few shots ago.
It is getting really interesting. You can just feel the pressure in the finals hall. Everyone's is silent and really trying to be calm, but it's really, really intense.
I felt it too. I was, funnily enough, it's funny you said that time. I was just about to mention that myself, that there's a huge crowd gathered here. The concentration, not only from the shooters, the coaches, but also from the crowd who are gathered here is nothing short of incredible. So we have our next elimination from this final, representing the Czech Republic. It's Gabriela Bognarova. Again, she smiles as she comes away to take her seat, starts unbuttoning her suit straight away. Now, I haven't tried one of those suits on just yet, but...
You haven't?
No, not quite. I should do.
Yes, you should.
I mean, I've had a go at rifle shooting myself, but... but I haven't done it yet. I'm sure, obviously, I'd become instantly world-class as soon as I...
Absolutely.
The suit...
No doubt about it.
It's got everything to do with the equipment, not my ability, Miguel. So it's Chandela of India who still leads. And now there's a difference of 0.6. So this gap keeps changing. It was 0.7, 0.3... That's 0.6, but even still, I mean, the margins we're talking about here, I mean, it literally is how it sounds. 0.6 is...
Yeah, it's nothing.
It's hardly anything. Well, it's something, isn't it? But it's so, so fine.
Well, of course, for Chandela, she's got it, well, on her side, you could say, but it can all change in one shot. Although she's just put in a 10.8, so looks like he won't change.
And receives a huge round of applause here. And there's people in the crowd almost shaking their head in not only just disbelief, but just the ability of some of the Indian team.
Amazing scores.
Now there's a difference of an entire point now between Wu Mingyan of China and Chandela of India. I mean, really, when it comes to these finals such as this, such as the 10-metre air rifle at women's, it's no surprise at this time to see that it's India and China in the 1-2 position.
No, not at all. They have been dominating this discipline for quite some time now.
So this is Wang, the second Chinese athlete in this final, currently ranked fifth. So unless her position improves, she will be eliminated from this final. She's currently 1.3 behind Ibsen of Denmark. That's quite a big margin to make up, 1.3, but we have seen things like that change. I mean, Wu has just scored a 10.7 there. This time, I mean, I say only a 9.9 from Chandela of India.
Yes, but that's, again, that's the thing. It takes literally nothing to go from a 10.9 to a 9.9.
So it did stay the same as before that shot. So finishing fifth in this final of the People's Republic of China on 186.1 is Wang Luyao.
0.3 between third and fourth place.
Now this is incredibly tight. Now when you get to the final, this really is the bit where the pain...
These next two shots are absolutely horrible.
Yes, because you've made the final.
Yeah.
You've now made it to the medal stages.
You're so close,
You're so close. So some clapping from the crowd as they try to encourage the shooters in the final stages of this final. We're down to the final four athletes. It's Ibsen of Denmark, Wu of China, Lin of Chinese Taipei, and Chandela of India, who still leads.
A 5.9.
So, yes, we are seeing a 5.9 from Chandela of India.
I didn't expect that.
Which really will change things so dramatically. So she literally dropped from first to fourth position. She's clearly faltered. We said anything can happen in shooting.
Yeah. She just proved it. Unfortunately for her, I really feel for her. That's
tough. That's clearly the pressure or the nerves just showing here in this final. Apurvi Chandela has dropped from first position to fourth, so drops outside the medals, and is now some way off third position. It's Lin of Chinese Taipei. Meanwhile, Denmark, Ibsen, moves up to
second place.
Moves up to second position, and it's now Wu of the People's Republic of China, 198.1. What a final we're witnessing here. If you've just joined us, you've joined at the right time.
Like I can see on the... on a Chandela screen that the 5 was high. That's like a little arrow pointing towards the top of the screen. So she most likely, like her trigger finger must have like flitched or something.
Something's happened, hasn't it? To be that consistent and to be leading for so long, to then almost go to a half score, if you like, and score a 5.
Exactly. I think it's pretty obvious, like when she was coming down onto the target, her finger must have flitched or something.
I think so, Mikhail, because she scored a 10.5 there, but because of that 5.9, it's not enough.
No, unfortunately for her, a really, really great final.
You've got to feel for her.
Yeah.
Apurvi Chandela has led all the way apart from that 5.9 shot. She looks so disappointed, but smiles nonetheless.
Yeah.
And Stanislav Lapoulos, coach next to her, is, well, that's life.
Yes, it is. Unfortunately.
She still has a silver medal to her name from the World Cup final in Munich. She also got a bronze at Changwon in 15 in the World Cup, and also represented her country at the Olympic Games, but that was almost 4 years ago. So 2 years ago in 2016. So no doubt we'll have her sights on Tokyo in 2020. But Sally leaves this final without a medal. However, it does now leave us with Lin of Chinese Taipei in third position. Ibsen of Denmark has performed so well throughout this final. She sat there consistently throughout fifth, sixth position, and then up to fourth, and is now in a silver medal position if she can maintain her composure and her form.
I'm really nervous right now, I have to admit. Three 10.5, so that's really consistent.
So every shooter equal 10.5 for all three shooters, which is incredible at this stage.
Yes, it is. Absolutely. Like a 10.5, that's That's around an average shot, at least
for this standard.
Yes, at least for these athletes, it is.
And when you come to shoot as well, you do hear someone shoot first, so yeah. You know.
You can feel the pressure sometimes. Oh, this is a close one.
This could go either way.
Yeah, both of them look calm.
I mean, there's a difference at the moment of 0.4 between third position and first, between the bronze and gold medal. There's a massive round of applause and cheer from the crowd. I think that's for Lin of Chinese Taipei, who has scored a 10.5. It means we have our first medal of this final. I know Mikkel's pleased.
Yeah, I'm really happy.
I can
this.
See the smile on his face.
I'm really happy.
He's sitting crossed arm, but I think Mikkel is yes. even going to applaud his fellow teammate. There she is. Like Meng Ibsen of Denmark has won a bronze medal.
Coach looks happy.
Yeah.
As kisses, well as he should.
Kisses all round.
Yeah.
A nice little scrunch at the our cameramen.
Yeah. Amazing.
So Denmark have their first medal, not only of the day, but of this competition as well. Long may that continue for you,
yes.
Mikkel. Here we go then. It's People's Republic of China versus Chinese Taipei.
But only 0.1, so it's basically a shoot-off.
Precisely. This is so close. Wu on 229.1. Ling, as Mikkel said, only just in front on 229.2. And it's a 10.4 from Wu. Let's see what Lin shoots here.
And amazing. She's still a junior, Lin, which is just incredible that she can perform so well under this kind of pressure.
Yeah,
exactly.
There we are. A 10.9, and the crowd lets you know. I mean, she's still only 19 years old. She celebrated her 19th birthday just a few weeks ago.
Incredible.
And here we go, 0.5, which again, even at this stage of the final, Mikkel, it's
like we've seen a 5 in this final, which just proves that anything can happen. So I don't think we should call this one yet.
And we saw a 5 from the leader.
Yes, exactly.
Here's Lin for her final shot.
Taking her time. Looking calm. 10.3.
10.3, so it's enough. So the difference remains at 0.5 between Chinese Taipei and the People's Republic of China. They're delighted. I'm sure she is too. She is. There we have it. There's the smile. As she packs away her rifle, the applause continues. Some whoops as well from the crowd here in Munich. So the first gold medal of this World Cup goes to Chinese Taipei, and it goes to Lin Ying-Shin on a final total of 250.3.
Which is a good final. And again, especially considering that she's still a junior, just makes it even better.
Yeah, she's only 19 years old and has a lot of shooting in front of her. It's Wu Mingyang of the People's Republic of China who gets the silver medal on 249.8. And there she is on our screens, yes. Rika Ibsen.
Looking really happy.
She is indeed. She raises her arms, the flashes of the cameras go, and smiles all round, and applause from this Munich crowd. Here's the silver medalist representing the People's Republic of China, Wu Mingyang, 249.8. Again, smiles and a wave to the crowd.
Yeah. And she's got reason to be happy. Like, she's doing so well.
Well, her silver medal for Wu, that adds to the gold medal that she won in Fort Benning just a few weeks ago in the World Cup. She was fourth in Changwon last month, and then fourth in New Delhi in the World Cup last year in 2017. So as Mikkel says, she'll be happy. And it's Lin Ying-Shin of Chinese Taipei who wins the gold medal on 250.3. And there she is standing there with her ever so technical rifle.
Yes.
Which we know weighs between 4.5 and 5.5 kilos.
It does.
But she makes it almost look like a feather as she raises it above her head. What an amazing, incredible performance. What a final as well. Just as you were
really
saying, Mikel,
yeah,
as well, that anything literally can change. You were saying
and
that
anything, everything did, basically.
You were saying the pressure was mounting. You could feel it in the room. And then we went and saw a 5.9 from Chandela of India, who was leading for so long. So there we go. The end of the first final. It's our only final for today. There is how it finished on your screens for you on day one here at the ISSF World Cup here in Munich. So that concludes the 10-metre air rifle women's final. Thank you very much to Mikel Hansen of Denmark.
My pleasure.
For being my guest this afternoon. It was brilliant to have you here. And we're Facebook friends now.
Yes,
so
we are.
Everything's going to be absolutely rosy from now on. We'll be fine. My name is Rory McAllister, and from everyone here at ISSF TV, thank you for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow.
The bronze medal representing Denmark goes to Rika Meng Ibsen. The silver medal representing the People's Republic of China goes to Wu Mingyang. And the gold medal representing Chinese Taipei goes to Lin Ying-Shin. So ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Chinese Taipei. So whilst the photos are taken, let's congratulate the winners of the 10-metre air rifle women's event one more time. Rika Meng Ibsen, Wu Ming Yang, and our gold medal winner, Lin Ying-Shin. And that, ladies and gentlemen, human men, human women, that concludes this victory ceremony. We'll see you tomorrow.